Hey guys, I'm LB, and we are back for more Talos Principle Test Chambers in Portal 2. Number 27 is what we will start off with. The first part of this map shows you that reflector cubes can float when they are connected with a laser source and a laser receiver. Here are some alternative titles. A level slightly advanced, red and blue, floating laser. Alright, so we have to abuse that bug, I'm assuming. Let's get going. Well, alright then. So let's start here. Here is a cube we can use. That's interesting, why is there an area back here behind Fizzler? That Fizzler can be disabled, apparently. So if we do this, we should be able to aim at that other guy there, right? Another laser cube in here. Gimme. Why do we have portals in here? That is very worrisome. That's all we need for the exit? Oh dear. What does this do? What does this do? I don't even know what these do. This is quite difficult looking, to say the least. Not really sure what to do here, actually. What do these do? I don't really need this guy under here anymore. Oh, don't tell me he's trapped. Fine. Oh, and that updates the cube. New. How did that update the cube? Come on, game. Ha. Come on, there's gotta be a way to do that. There has to be. Thank you. weird. Oh, come on. I might not even be possible here, in this case. It's whenever the button changes. I guess it's not possible, because it stays floating until the button changes, which updates it somehow. Huh. I do not know what to do in that case. Oh. wait. What? Can I make that angle work? No, there is not a way to make that work. Not in a million years. Although, once I've angled this, do I really need to be in here anymore? Maybe I don't. Maybe I do? Maybe I bid you adieu? I really don't know. This really is quite perplexing. Oh, wrong cube. What are these buttons for? Okay, so now I am definitely trapped, unless I reload my save. And unless these buttons do something I'm not aware of. Like that, for instance. Okay, but... how do I get back in there, though? I don't know, I really don't know what I'm doing here right now. The fizzler's still up. Unless I put a cube on that button there, and I don't know how to do that. I don't even know what the fizzler surface is for. So that definitely is the only requirement for the exit. I feel like I'm supposed to somehow bring that cube with me, but I already demonstrated that it's not possible. I think I have an idea. There we go. Ah, crap. There we go, that's what I wanted. Only problem is... how does that help me, though? I literally don't see how that helps me. Yeah, I don't see how that helps me at all. So earlier when I thought that the button was updating the cube, it's actually just because when this closes, the laser gets cut off and the cube stops floating. I really do not know what to do here. So this stumped Nock as well. No, I don't see how this helps me at all. I think I got it. Maybe. No, like, it doesn't really matter which cubes I bring, though. I don't think it does anyway. Thank you. maybe I can get all three cubes this way. Perhaps. Yeah, because then I can get out here and recall the other one. Okay, so maybe this does help. Ah! Oh! Wow, okay. That's actually pretty simple. I like that. Got it! The trick was to get this cube out here. Let's see. So now the trick. We're not done yet, though! Oh no, we're not done yet. That is quite frightening, the fact that we're not done yet. Okay, well. We can do this, right? But it still doesn't help much. Oh, you know what? I can put this here. And I can aim at that from on this button. I was thinking about this earlier, but I forgot about it until just now. Do that. Yeah, there you go. That's how you do it. Here's the real mystery. Something tells me I've already messed up, but I'm gonna keep trying to go anyway. This laser is not where I expect it to be. Yep. Like, we've made some kind of forward progress, right? I think we need to swap the laser cubes again. That'll help. Okay, so we've swapped the laser cubes. That way, when we can do... Wait... No, maybe it won't help at all. Maybe. Still not sure about this whole area here. This is still rather confusing to me. Don't actually understand what the purpose of it all is. Okay, so yeah, that did what I expected it to. What is this antline? Oh, this button. Not exactly sure what to do at this point. Cause that disables the fizzler. But I can't actually use it. What if... No, that wouldn't work. Why does this antline go such a long way around? Wait a sec. No, no, no. I think I may have figured it out. Maybe. I mean, I can figure out how to open the exit anyway. That's something, right? Opening the exit is half the battle, right? Laser is just slightly too far. There, that's something. Right? That at least counts for something. The exit is now open. But I have no way of getting to it. I haven't even gotten a chance to use that wall back there yet. That button as one of them, and this button as the other. The thing is, we need all three cubes to even open this area for the light bridge. When this is open, these are closed. And when those are open, this and this are closed. Like, it really feels like I'm supposed to take that cube and put it there, but then when I do that, I trap myself. I think I'm gonna make like Nock and take a break, because there's, I can't figure out what to do after this. So, I guess that's the end of part zero. As always, thank you for watching, I really appreciate it. You can show your appreciation with the couple buttons below the video. I will see you all in the next episode. Goodbye! Okay, I'm back. It's a new day. It's actually been a week, basically, since I played this map. And I really... still not sure what to do. Sleeping several days, repeatedly, has not really jogged my memory in any useful way. But I have thought about this in a more logical manner, so we know we have to have this laser go into there, so we need a cube at this height, and it's probably gonna have to be floating, because in order for... I'm still confused about what this is for, but in order to even activate it, we need... oh, I know what that's for. That's so we can get back over there, once the exit is open, but in order to do that, we need something on this button and something on that button. Which means, the three cubes we have are the three cubes, the only three cubes we get, basically, because that's the minimum that we need. I'm not sure how to pull this off, though. First things first, let's start by recalling this guy here. That's done that, right? So I think, first of all, we'll definitely want to put him here. And then, what do we do next? That's the confusing part. We want to recall this guy. See, that throws a wrench in the works. Why does that close? That is very unnerving. Anyway, so we want to go in here, right? And then here's the problem. We can't get anywhere, really. See, this is the problem, I don't know what to do here. fizzler definitely turns off when we do this, though. What if we temporarily swap these cubes? Like, we put this on this button and then we can recall it while we're in there, right? That's at least something. I don't know if we tried this in the first half of this episode. Cause, like I said, it's been a week. That allows us to do this. But we have to always keep something on that button now, and that's a problem. And now we have this. Problem is... Oh... Okay. I think I get it now. We need to swap the laser cubes. Because I did not have them in the right arrangement. Alright. Let's see. Sir are coming with me. Because we want to be able to fire our black portal. Do that, then we go into here, recall cube. We do... Okay, well that kinda works, but I wanna get it more on there. There we go. Do that, and that cube's gonna stay in there so that we can pull it out later. Call this one, that one is still in there. Good, good, good. Then we swap these. That there. There we go. We head over here, put this on here, then we recall it while we're inside. We put it on this button, and that opens the fizzler for us. And so now, we want to shoot our black portal. And now we have all the cubes and the portals set up the way we want. Cubes and portals. So now what we need to do... How are we gonna do that? We have to swap the cubes again. Let's see. This one on here. So that we can, see. Oh, give me this cube, please. Oh, because this one's floating. Do this. Right? Maybe. I think so, yes. We put this here. And then we recall that one, because we swapped the cubes. Man, this is cube swapping galore. And then... Let's see. Now we can do this. The exit is open. And now we just need to re-put this guy. Take him. go back inside. We recall and put it on the button, and we're done. Holy crap! That is an involved puzzle. I really did need to sleep on this for a week, because that was... that's insanely complex. Well, guys, that concludes this episode. Thank you so much for watching, I really appreciate it, and thank you for being worried about my headache. It was just that I had a headache for a few hours while I was batch recording, and I really appreciate you guys being worried, but I'm better now. I do not have a headache anymore, and that's probably why I was able to solve this. So yeah, this is an awesome, extremely difficult puzzle. I really like it a lot. Let me add this to my favorites. This is absolutely crazy. I think that is the hardest logic puzzle that I've ever done. That is very, very involved. You had to swap the cube so many times. I'm sure Flooper's gonna tell me you didn't have to swap the cube that time, but whatever. Man. Alright, thank you so much for watching. I will see you all in the next episode, and goodbye. Oh yeah, don't forget to show your appreciation with one of the two buttons below.